for week 47 of the COVID tapes, or as somebody called the Vendetti tapes. Anyway, so we're going to play some beautiful bebop, but it's Valentine's Day today, so this is our Valentine's presentation. Bebop is a very passionate and fiery music with a lot of love in there too. So we'll be playing that, but we will go a little towards the ballad side along the way. Let me introduce this wonderful band of musicians. Modesto Brezena, you all know. Jeff Saxton, you all know. Sylvia Cuenca, you all know. But our special guest today, and I'm so glad that he made the huge trip down from Sacramento to join us. He was one of the first guys I kind of hooked up with in the Bay Area when I got here. And it was all smooth sailing from that point forward in terms of finding guys who played the kind of stuff I play. His name is Joe Gilman, the great Joe Gilman on piano. We're going to start, I'll talk some stuff in between, but we're going to start with a Charlie Parker composition. This is from kind of the pre-bop era, in a way, before bebop became known with a name. And so it uses a rhythm that Kenny Clarke used to play called the mop-mop rhythm. It's called Red Cross.
One, two, one, two.
Super Bowl Sunday last week. I know it's a big deal over here, but for those of you who did, you have exquisite taste. So there's that. And then I've got to say a disclaimer about this political stuff that's going on over here. Of course, I'm not from here, but I've been here for 30 years. None of this surprises me, but it's not the way we think in jazz. Jazz is about truth. And in that sense, the ears never lie. If you understand what you are hearing, as Duke Ellington said, if it sounds good and feels good, it is good. So we have a whole different sense of justice in our system, and we're going to talk about it a little later. But anyway, it's Valentine's Day. So, whoopee, I hope you're all having a great day. We are having a super day. We have lots of loved ones here. Very nice. So we're gonna play a ballad in the next tune. We don't normally do that this early, but the ballad is from an album by Jimmy Heath that he made before he passed away last year. It didn't come out till August last year. He passed away in January. And I'm not sure that he got all of the things on that he wanted, but there's more than enough material to sum up everything about this great, great master in jazz. So we're going to play a ballad off his last album, and we're going to play another tune off that album a bit later too. But the ballad is called Ballad for Upper Neighborhood Suite, is that right? Upper Neighbor's Suite, yeah. So I'm not very good with words, but I'm going to do something now, which is a big risk. And so, like, a lot of people play ballads, you know, a lot of musicians sing. You might hear, you know, Chet Baker, who would sing a tune on a ballad like this, and or do something like that for Valentine's Day. But I'm going to do what Dexter Gordon used to do. And he could sing, but he chose not to, and probably wisely, really. Like, but all those musicians back then, they had to sing out of necessity. It was like part of the gig. So whether it was Bird or any of the guys around him, they were all balladeers of sorts. But what Dexter did, I always remember, was he would say the words of the ballad and then play the ballad. So here it is, guys. It's going to test my memory or anything, but that's how I learn ballads. So we'll see how it goes. And I don't think I've played this tune for years. I'm going to say it with a certain amount of gravitas, but it's nothing like the way Dexter used to do it. So, my funny Valentine. Sweet comic Valentine. You make me smile with your heart. Your lips are laughable, and they're unphotographable. Yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? When you open it to speak, are you smart? That could go back to the political discourse, but anyway. Don't say a prayer for me, not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine, stay. Each day is Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody.
Can I get a blowjob?
No.
No, okay. Oh, well. All right, so here's Jimmy Heath's great tune. Check his album out. It's called Love Letters.
One, two, three.
Oh,
Album with, who was it? Well, with Tudy and Tony Perrone and
Kitagawa.
Yeah, I should know that. Sorry.
Yoshi.
Yeah, right. Kiyoshi Kitagawa. Anyway, we try to let you know the great recordings to have. I think that was one of the great recordings from last year, along with Charles McPherson's great recording that we've played a few tunes off, Jazz Dance Suite. So this week was another bad week for jazz because we lost a really fine piano player. His name is Chick Corea. And the outpouring of tributes to him is indication of his personality and his greatness. Music obviously crosses a lot of barriers, but he was known for really reaching out to musicians. Everything was a personal situation with anyone who came across, anyone he played with. Didn't matter where they came from, how they played, what they played, whatever it was. He was curious, inquisitive, and it showed up in every part of his music. So we think it's good to do a bit of a tribute to that. We're going to play a tune. I remember it from the album with Stan Getz. I think the album was called Sweet Rain. It's a particularly brilliant tune. It's called Windows. We hope you enjoy our version of Windows.
You gonna go straight in?
Thank you.
Throw it to him again, and as usual in jazz, he comes up with something absolutely brilliant, but that's what we kind of do. So, all right. So that's Windows by the great, great Chick Corea. So we're going to follow that. This has a history with me, but also a history for a long while, because I used to have a band in Australia when I was a kid, we used to play this, and then when I played with Nat Adley, we used to play this. But when I started a band in San Francisco 20 years ago, I got Joe down to play the piano. It was a sextet, and you were playing on trumpet, right? Mo was playing on trumpet. We had Akira Tanner on drums, Michael Zisman on bass, And a colleague of mine playing tenor saxophone named Hafez Meduzadeh, and we all rocked through this tune. It's a beautiful tune. It's a tune by Victor Feldman. Features the piano and the melody and all other things. So no pressure, but the real deal. This is Azul Serape.
Thank you.
That's how we like to do it, people. I guess you could say we got to do it our way in the end because that's what we got. But that's the great thing about jazz. Again, Modesto Brezzagno on the trumpet, Jeff Saxon on the double bass, Sylvia Cuenca on the drums, and our very special guest today, the great Joe Gilman. So that was Azul Serape by Victor Feldman. Next we're going to do a tune, it's actually on the album Love Letters, done in a different way to the original. So we're going to try and play it a little bit like the way Jimmy Heath played it on his last recording. And that featured the beautiful trumpet playing on the melody by Wynton Marsalis. So a shout out goes to him. A shout out also goes to my dear friend in Australia, the great trumpet player that I grew up with, taught me a lot. Pretty much every time he played, and a lot of the time I had to follow him, and I fumbled my way through it. His name is Warwick Alder. We are playing this tune for you, and we're going to play another one for you a little later that you will remember very well. All right, this one is called La Misha by Kenny Donovan. Thank you. Tune. This is all kind of our romantic side of bebop. So the next tune, we're not going to play it in its regularly kind of conceived way of playing it, because it's normally a ballad. We're going to turn it into a bossa nova, but it's really by the bebop trombone player. He's much grander than that, because he composed and arranged, did film scores, television shows, everything else. But he changed the way trombone players think and play. Super great guy. His name is J.J. Johnson. And this is his probably most well-used and famous tunes, at least amongst great jazz musicians. This is called Lament. We hope you enjoy Lament.
Thank you. Valentine's Day,
and we're going to be here for as many weeks as it takes with all of this stuff. And we have a little sign on the back which has tips and stuff. And we've been doing this consistently for a real reason. There's a lot of musicians who struggle out there. The tips don't go to us. Some of us in the band have professional careers doing a lot of other things. In fact, pretty much all of us are educators in certain ways, and some of us are more together in that department than others. But we help our band out first, but then the next thing we do with our tips is we send it around the musicians that really need desperate help in our local area and everything else. So please give, because it's super important. The arts in America is totally underappreciated. If COVID has taught you anything, it's that nobody gives a damn about the arts. I'm not just talking about jazz, about everything. So they need to get it together as a democracy over here, because a democracy would mean that kind of stuff is the fabric and the foundation of everything that is great about a democracy. So, see, it always ends up circular. So I talked about the lunacy going on in DC. We are not part of that. We don't believe in it. And none of us up here, because we think about things, can really follow through on the arguments that are being there. It's so spineless and so weak. You know, good enough. The Democrats, oh well, what they do is good enough for government work. They did their best, but they're not really thinking out of the box. All right, with that being said, this is Evidence, or based on another tune called Just You, Just Me. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Oh, Dale Gilman.
Jeff Saxton, Sylvia Quanky, yours truly, Andrew Spake. Tune in live at 5 next week for some more political and religious commentary. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you.